Hello guys, welcome to Amit Thinks. In this video, we will learn how to install the current MySQL version on Windows 10. We will install MySQL Server Shell as well as Workbench. After installing, refer to our free MySQL tutorial. The link is in the description of this video. Let's start. Open any web browser. Type MySQL and press enter. Now the official website is visible. Click on it. Here is the official website. Click downloads. Go below. Click MySQL Community GPL downloads. Now click MySQL installer for Windows. Here is the current version 8.0.37 and it's for Windows. Two versions are visible. I'll go for the following one. It works for both 32-bit as well as 64-bit Windows 10 operating system. Click the below one. Download 296 MB. Click no thanks, just start my download. Here it is. Let's wait. It's 296 MB. We have downloaded. Right click and click open. Minimize. The installation started. Choose a setup type. I'll go for custom. Click next. Here you will be able to select what you are installing. Under select products, click MySQL servers, drop down, and here is the current version. Drag it. Now go to applications, workbench. Drag it to install workbench also, and the same for shell. Now we have our three versions. Click next. Now ready to install server, workbench and shell. Click execute. Now they'll get installed. The installation is complete. Click next. Ready to configure. Click next. Type and networking. The port number is 3306. Authentication method. Keep the default. Strong password encryption. Click next. MySQL root password. Herein you need to add your own password. Some people face difficulties in creating a password here, so you can use my password also. It's on a local system only, not on your server, so you don't need to worry about. I have provided a random password here, that's it. Click next. Now root is our admin. Click next. Windows service. Click next. File permissions, yes, grant full access. So herein, in this location, your databases will get saved. You can copy this location. Click next. Apply configuration. Click execute. We have installed MySQL 8.0.37. Click finish. Click next. It will also start MySQL Workbench and shell. No problem. Click finish. Meanwhile, it is starting. We will set the path. Go to your MySQL path. It was in C drive, program files, MySQL, server, bin, and copy this path. right click copy, go to start, type environment variables and click on edit the system environment variables, that is open. Under advanced, click environment variables. Okay, go to system variables, double click on the path variable, new, and right click, paste the same MySQL bin path. Okay, okay, and the last okay. Now go to start, type cmd, open it. Now let us verify MySQL space hyphen hyphen version, press enter. We successfully installed the current MySQL version. Now you can also start MySQL server MySQL space hyphen u. This means u means user, that was root, and space hyphen p, p means password. When you'll press enter, it will ask for the same password. Enter the same password which you have set before. Press enter. Now we are inside our MySQL. Now let us check the default databases. The command is show databases. Okay. Now let us create a new database. Create database command. Database name AmitDB and press enter. Successfully created. Type the same command show databases and press enter. Here is our database AmitDB. Okay. Now let us check the location of this AmitDB. I told you it will be under the data folder, C drive. Go to program data. If you are unable to find this, it's hidden. I have enabled it. You just need to go to view and select this option, hidden items. Just select it to enable it. Now the program data will be visible. Go inside it, MySQL, server, and data. So herein you can click continue. So herein you can find your databases. So I just created AmitDB database. Okay. You can also take a backup of databases from here. Minimize. Now, if you remember, we were having our workbench. Here it is. Let us start it. And it started. So guys, this is a UI to create a MySQL databases and tables and perform operations. Okay. In this video, we saw how we can install the current MySQL version. Thank you for watching.